not necessary to be that close to an AWACS and the Carrier Strike Group. You guys are beyond visual range fighters. I can't tell if this is the look of focus or the look of I need to take a shit. They're tracking F-35s and Valkyries out a lot further than they probably should be able to realistically. It could be the result of a bad aspect in relation to the radar. And as for jets out immediately, I don't know what the hell they're talking about, so that's definitely a plus two for me. Change your course or you'll be considered an enemy. That's kind of harsh, but it's not too far off. If you don't change course, they will end up splashing you or attempting to, because they don't know what the hell you're doing. So I guess I'll let that one slide. That's a good way to start a worldwide conflict right there, so you would probably get your ass handed to you by the time you get back. If it's not by the bandits, it would be by your higher-ups. I think they tried to pick an A9M or A120 launch here, but they end up kind of looking like Russian R-73s because they kind of have these angle attack gauges by the stabilization fins in the back, but they have the paint of A120s. I don't know what these are. These are completely fictional. As for the Valkyrie's turn here, it's not even in service yet, but I'm really doubting it's going to be able to turn that aggressively. And that's because of its ruderator design there, and lack of an afterburner, it looks like. I don't know for sure, because it's not in service yet, but I'm going off what I'm seeing here, so I could be right, could be wrong, but for now, it is a sin for me. Why not just say 1-1 defending, or defensive, or 1-2 defensive, whatever, tomato-tomato, because they communicate the same message. The message being, hey, I am this guy, and I'm defending a missile, or guns, or an aircraft, or something. It just helps with communication, so everyone knows what's going on, and that kind of helps counteract the fog of war and all that jazz. Also, his chaff and flares should be just a switch on the throttle, or the joystick in the F-16's case. You should really only have it on the console if it's an emergency jettison, or something similar like that. Doing an Elon roll while dumping chaff and flares is going to do f*** all for you. And while keeping your afterburners on, if they are heat-seeking, they're going to continue to follow your engine. Terrible idea, regardless of the generation of aircraft. What the f***? He just flopped out of the air by moving his stick a little to the left. In all honesty, you're not going to stall just by moving your stick a little bit to the left, and it's not going to be just like that. It's going to be gradual, you can start losing control, and then that's when you fall. He dumps nose, goes into a thicker atmosphere, and goes cold, which is going away from the enemy or the missile in this case, which can work to bleed off the missile's airspeed, but as we can see, it has infinite rocket propellant because of movie magic bullshittery. So that's not working here, so I'll give him some credit on that. That is kind of realistic. Missiles do lead pursuit, which is the act of trying to actively predict where they're going, where the target is going. That would have just caused the missile to just pull up and away from the water. But there is still a chance he could have kinetically defeated it here, but I'm counting this as a sin because the missile refused to even pull up to begin with. What is it with y'all and wanting to make your aircrafts fall like a f***ing brick here? Is that just referencing Ip Man? Because I fail to see the relevance. They're just making them try to outrun them as a defense, which is not going to happen because single engine versus twin engine. But you're also, from a storytelling perspective, hyping these guys up like they're the big bad wolf and then making them run at like a moment's notice. That is really confusing. That kind of gets rid of a lot of tension.
Under 10 of the jurisdiction. Change your course immediately, or you will be intercepted.
We can come and go whenever we want.
This is literally the second f***ing time they've said this. Ignoring the fact they just plagiarized a bit from Top Gun Maverick here, they should have seen him coming from miles away. They have the Northrop Grumman ANAAQ-37 distributed aperture system. This gives all F-35s 360-degree spherical coverage around the aircraft against anything they could see on IR. It could be surface-to-air missiles, it could be other aircraft, it could be missile launches, even RPGs on the ground. And it allows passive tracking of aircraft, so they could actually launch AMRAAMs and have them go forwards and then do a U-turn back at the aircraft. So they have to defend or die, basically. So they had a lot of options here. I don't get why they didn't see them. I know this is probably a propaganda movie more than anything, but they made it look like these things are just super easy to fight and that they're just completely incompetent. And putting patriotism aside, what that's done is you've given your protagonist an antagonist that cannot fight worth a damn, which creates no tension and therefore a lot of predictability. And it gives a sense of, oh yeah, I already know who's gonna win. And there's no like what if factor to it at that point. It just kind of makes it a little bit boring to watch. Once again, 1-1 defending, 1-2 defensive, tomato tomato, and also his chaff and flares are apparently not on the throttle. They should be on the throttle quadrant for the F-35. And because of that, 2 sins for me, because this has happened twice now. Extra 3 sins for him continuing to turn reverse into his HUD. For the ones that play DCS or VTOL VR, you will know why this is a problem. It's saying failure to lock. It's not gonna typically say that in an aircraft. It's just gonna try to lock the flares instead. That's the whole point of it. It's 5th generation, not 4th generation. I'm gonna write this off as a translation error, but I'm still sending it because this hurts my soul.
25. That's enough!
I'm sending this because even though the F-35A can do this, the F-35C most likely cannot sustain this kind of alpha. And here's a clip of the F-35A doing a very similar maneuver at an air show. This gets a pass for me because merges outside of a training environment, they could get this close if it's an actual fight. The training rules are only there to prevent pilots from killing each other during practice. Once again, as I've said before, the F-35A can possibly do a turn like this, but the F-35C cannot. The F-35C has a 7.5G limit, it won't have the nose 40, nor the alpha to do a turn like this. You'd most likely need thrust vectoring to even think about doing this. Along with it, he does the wrong stick inputs. He goes full stick to the right, and despite going full stick to the right, it shows him doing a full, what is that, 70-degree bank and full stick aft, which makes him slide to 80 alpha, that looks like. And along with it, the vapor effects look like absolute dog shit. It looks like smoke coming off the wings. So that's gonna be at least 3 sins from me, because they f***ed up the turn, the stick inputs, and the vapor effect on top of it. Not only did he forget to maneuver in relation to the bandit, they also just straight up ripped the first contact cutscene from Ace Combat 7. This movie is just fucking shameless. It's copying things left and right now. This is the third time I'm saying this now, but you're just making them look like punching bags so you have your power fantasy. It removes any tension from the movie, and just kind of makes it boring and cliche to watch. And from a dogfighting perspective, going vertical is only good if you're going to be doing a loop. If you're just going to climb, go straight vertical against the bandit that's that close to you, it's not going to do anything to begin with.